Jesus Christ, our way, our life. Word of God among us, fed the poor and cured the sick, gave yourself to save
today
us.
We celebrate the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. We are celebrating our God. We know that our God is known as the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Not to say that there are three gods, but one God in three persons, the Trinity. Celebrating this sermon today gives us a chance once again to reflect on which kind of God do we believe in, which kind of God do we serve, which kind of God do we love, and which kind of God cares for us. And we assert that truly our God is a triune God, three persons in one. The scriptures, in a special way, give us the evidence that truly our God is in three persons, but one God. From the creation of the world, the book of Genesis says, in the beginning, the earth was a formless void. The Spirit of the Lord was hovering around the whole world, and God created the world on the first day. By His word, He said, let there be light. Already, the introduction of Genesis gives us that we already have the three persons. However, God had not revealed Himself to the fullest. They are not well expressed in the beginning that they are three. Even in the creation story, when God created Adam and Eve, He said, let us make man, let us. This plural already shows us we have more than one person, but we don't have more than one God. Already pointing to a reality that our God is a majestic God. In Him, we have the many. And this is going to be revealed in the fullness of time. One by one, God is going to reveal Himself how truly He is. And the fullness of the revelations is going to be attained in Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. Let us look also in the Gospels at the Annunciation. God gives us another time to know that truly He is God, but in Him we have the Father, we have the Spirit, and we await the Son. In the message of the angel Gabriel, behold, you will conceive, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, you bear a son of the Most High. God the Father sends the angel Gabriel. The angel Gabriel promises the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, and Mary conceives the Son of the Most High. And so we have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. At the Annunciation, God is also revealing to us that this reality of the triuneness of God is present. Also, at the baptism of Jesus Christ, when Jesus was baptized, a clear distinction is made. When He was being baptized, the voice came from the clouds. Behold, this is my Son, in whom I am well pleased. The Spirit of God came in the form of a dove unto Jesus Christ. Again, the three persons of the Trinity. The Father speaking, the Holy Spirit in the form of a dove, and the Son who was being baptized. Today, when we celebrate the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity, We are not celebrating something that is new. We are not celebrating a reality that is far distant from who God is. But we celebrate the true nature of God, that is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Though we celebrate this distinct reality of the three persons, the scriptures once again assert to us that truly God is one. In the words of Jesus Christ, when John asked him, "But Master, show us your Father," Jesus replied, "John, don't you know, having seen me, you have seen my Father? Because I am in my Father, and my Father is in me." This shows truly that our God is not separated, is not different. In God, we have the three persons always present, always one. But with time, God has given us the opportunity. He has revealed himself according to the time. We know him as the Creator, God the Father, because the creation was truly made by God the Father. It is emphasized, it is made anew, mainly as God the Father creating. Though we have also come to know that even in creation, the Word of God was present, because God created by his Word. We know it's God who is Jesus Christ. And at the same time, the Spirit of God was around. And so even in creation, the Spirit was around. But we come to know God the Father fully in creation. And more so, in the words of Jesus Christ, when Jesus Christ teaches us how to pray, he says, if you are to pray to God, say like this, "Our Father." And so we call him our Father. Though we know him as a creator, we also call him our Father. So he has a name. He is holy. By his name, we humans, we don't have even the guts to call upon him. But Jesus Christ gave us the audacity to say, he is our Father. And so, together with Jesus, we unite and say, our Father. And Jesus Christ, we call upon him. He's the Son of the Most Living God. He's our brother. But we call him Jesus. Because in Jesus Christ, like the name suggests, God saves. We who were sinners, we needed somebody to save us from our sins, to redeem us from the bondage of sin, the bondage of slavery. And God the Father sent his only begotten Son to pay the price. And so he is our Savior. He is the Yeshua. Therefore, we call God the Son Jesus, because he saves us. And not only that, we also know from history, we have come to know that he's the anointed one of God. He's the holy priest who is to make the one holy sacrifice that is pleasing to God the Father. And that sacrifice he made at Calvary. And therefore, we also come to know Jesus as the Christ, the anointed one. Secondly, the Holy Spirit. We know that God, Jesus Christ, promised us the Holy Spirit. And this Holy Spirit, last Sunday we celebrated the outpouring of the Holy Spirit unto the disciples and unto the whole church, that we who believe in Jesus Christ, we have a sure hope of following God by being in Jesus Christ. But out of fear, we tend not to have the life of God. And the Spirit of God coming into our midst fills us with this life of God. And therefore, the scriptures have already given us enough evidence that truly God is the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. though they are distinct, as God has revealed himself, but they always remain one. They always remain united. As we celebrate this reality, we also come to know even our lives have truly shown to us this reality of the Holy Spirit. God is present and in our lives as human beings, though we are not perfect, he has enabled us to know that truly, even us, we can comprehend that three things can be in one and remain in our reality. We take an example of the child who is in the womb. God has shown us that when a mother is pregnant, this one woman living, she can eat, she can talk, she can run, she can sleep. But inside the belly of a pregnant woman, there is another living being, truly human, truly living, with life endowed to this baby, with life to the fullest in this baby. Though this baby might be limited, cannot walk, cannot go away from the mother, but is truly a human being. If God, so powerful to make we human beings who have a body that is going to die, he makes us capable of holding another human being inside us, is it so difficult for God to be three persons in one God? It is not. And also, as human beings, when you look at me, I'm a person. But when those who know my mom, they will tell you, you talk like your mom, you resemble your mom to this extent. And when I walk with her, they'll be like, yeah, truly we can see the picture of your mom. And when I walk with my dad, the same, truly we see a picture of your dad. Does it not speak that in me, my mom is present? Doesn't it speak that in me, my dad is present? But it does not mean that when I stand here, they are within me. No, no, they are different. My mom and my dad and I, three persons. But in me alone, we have the three persons. That wherever I go, they will say, the son of so and so. And when I stand, they will say, no, that is Joseph. Even in us human beings, God has given us an opportunity to understand that truly being three in one, it is possible. So as we celebrate this ceremony, when we celebrate that truly our God can be three persons in one. However, like God revealed to Saint Augustine, we cannot put God in our heads. We cannot comprehend all realities of God. To truly understand how is God three persons in one, where does God the Father end, then God the Father with the Son come in, then the Holy Spirit was, how are they come, which formula is making them united? Our heads can't comprehend that. And so, in celebrating this ceremony, the first reading comes to us and shows to us the kind of God, the nature of God, that our God is a powerful God. Which kind of nation has a God that revealed himself by serving? Remember the Exodus story. God intervenes those who are in slavery. He does 10 miracles. He sends frogs, snakes. He turns water into blood. He sends sicknesses. He sends the angel who passes over and the firstborns die, but he spares his nation. A God who separates the sea into two halves and his people walk on dry land. The God who makes his followers, his children, to eat meat and bread and drink. In the desert, you eat bread flowing like rain. Which kind of God is that? Which kind of God is so merciful? He sends his only begotten son to die for us. Which kind of God is so powerful that even when death had taken over, he conquers death. And so is our God. So today we rejoice that the God we believe in is so powerful. There is no God that is so powerful, so loving, so caring like our God. So following this God, the gospel today tells us, we who are introduced in the life of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ gave us a formula that in our baptism, be baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. It is the life of the triune God in which we are introduced. And therefore, as we journey as Christians, always put together our God, journey with our God, the triune God. As Catholics, we are always told to make the sign of the cross. One, this sign of the cross is a reminder to us that our God is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And so, whatever we do, the scriptures call upon us to, whatever we do, do it in the name of God. And who is our God? The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And therefore, when the priests are blessing us, they will bless us in the name of the triune God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. When we are praying, when we gather, we begin our prayers, the priest always tells us, brothers and sisters, we have gathered in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, because we gather in the name of God. When we celebrate a Trinity with the triune God in our lives, many people come to wonder, how can God be three in one? How can we say we believe in God who is three? It's many think we believe in three gods, and many have failed to turn to God because of the reality that God is three in one. We as Christians, our role, believe in God, trust in Him, and trust in Him even those who don't believe. The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit will extend His divine hand, will extend His mighty hand to all nations, and He will draw them to the reality of His unity, to the reality of His love, to the reality of His oneness. The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit is our God. He is one, He is loving. He is one, and He has revealed Himself as truly Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us always draw to Him, and let us always not stop calling upon Him. The Lord be with you.
Jesus Christ, our way, our life.